Staph infection cases are growing by the day, and one place the bug is spreading is among high school athletic teams. But local programs are taking precautions to make sure this highly contagious and sometimes lethal infection doesn't invade their locker rooms.
Between Thursday and Saturday, Tad Gormley Stadium in City Park is a hotbed for high school football, but it can also be a breeding ground for staph infections.
How many times is this thing used every week? You scratch, you cut, scrape here, you pick up something from somebody else here, and then you bring it back to everybody you even brush up against, maybe, in your own team.
That's why area schools are taking measures to prevent it from affecting their players.
We actually have a health clinic at Old Perry Walker, and we had heard about the viruses and some things going around, and we just kind of kept an eye on our kids.
One thing we try to stress after practice and after a game is who's hurt. We don't care how small, just what it is, we need to treat it right away.
Warren Easton head coach Tony Hull echoes his athletic director's sentiments, and with good reason. When Hull was an assistant coach at Mandeville, several players became infected with staph.
We had one kid get it. We had one kid get on his forearm, and then another kid got it on his leg, and then another kid got another place, and then we had to take those kids and keep them isolated for a little while so no one else would be infected.
And if athletes do contract a staph infection, WDSU medical editor Dr. Corey Hebert says,
if you have a staph infection, generally if you clean the wound very well, then it should be okay. But if you do not clean the wound very well, you're going to need antibiotics and you have to go to your doctor. There's no other way you can treat this.
Both coaches also said their school nurses have taken measures to make sure the locker rooms are disinfected properly on a regular basis. And the Louisiana High School Athletic Association has listed helpful disinfectants on their website, as well as articles on how to prevent staph infections.